Have you ever wondered what games you should keep or you should lose? Find out here at Purge Views. Have you ever wondered what games you should sell or you should use? Find out here at Purge Views. Find out on our top 10 list what games you cannot miss. Don't forget to subscribe to Purge Views.
The components for Penny Arcade, the card game, are fairly easy. You're going to get a small little box, you're going to get some little tokens, and a bunch of cards. The rule book for Penny the Arcade is fairly colorful. It does have a lot of words in it, but some pictures. And you'll be able to learn how to play the game, especially if you ever played any deck builders, maybe 5 to 10 minutes max. It's a fairly easy game to learn how to play. Setup for the game is fairly easy. You're only going to have two characters in this game. You have Tycho, the evil genius, or Gabe, the boy wonder. Pretty much the strength is going to be different. Gabe's going to be a little bit stronger. The intellect for Tycho will be a little bit bigger than for the Boy Wonder. And the Boy Wonder will have a little bit more health. Each character will have their own deck of cards based on these characters at the bottom. You will shuffle their deck of cards and then flip them over. Each player will get enough life points equal to their start. You will draw a number of cards equal to your intellect. And then you're ready to begin the game. A turn of the game is going to equal three things. The first thing you can do is you can play a stuff card. The stuff card will have a green border on it. In this case, I'm going to play the watch. You receive +1 strength and +1 intellect. If a player loses 5 or more life in a turn, his opponent takes control of this card. So I will put this down here by the evil genius. The second thing you do on your turn is play a hijinks card, which is the blue bordered ones. In this case, look at the top 3 cards of your deck and rearrange them in any order. So I would take this card and I would make a discard pile, and I can draw 3 cards from my draw and put them in whatever order I wanted to after looking at them and placing it back down. In order to play a hijinks card, I must have at least this much intellect in order to play it. My character right now has a 7 in intellect, and this only requires a 2. So I could play that card. The last thing I can do on my turn is play an attack card, which will be signified by the red. In this card, discard the top 2 cards of your deck. If you discarded a success, your opponent may not block this attack. This little icon would signify a success. So I have successfully attacked, and they cannot block this. So he would take this much damage, which would be 3. And I'll continue to play until he's or I am out of health. I'll give you another example of an attack. If I had played the Mantis technique, if your opponent has 2 or fewer cards in hand and loses 1 health, I do not, but he does an attack of 3. Let's say I did have a card with the block ability, so I could block that 3. I would discard this card, and I would draw 3 cards from my deck. And if these have a success on it, which they do, then I have successfully blocked that card. What you're going to have here is you're going to have a game where you're going to be playing cards from your hand. You're going to have a few that you can switch from, and you can always have a stuff, a hijinks, an attack on a turn. So it's going to be very, very important about which cards you play and when, and kind of determine whether maybe your opponent has a block card or not, especially when you're attacking, because that's the main source here, right? The stuff is going to give you extra attributes. The hijinks are going to let you kind of break the rules and do things, and the attack is how you're going to theoretically win the game. But you're never going to know exactly what your opponent has. So you're just attacking blind, then have some random card draws to see if they're able to block it. I don't know if that is the best system. So what you're going to get here is a game that's highly, highly, highly reliant on luck. There's not a lot of long-term strategic planning because you only have a few cards, which is fine, but you can only play one of each round. And a lot of those are going to interact with your opponent, but you never know exactly what they have in their hand. Of course, as the game progresses, I mean, this deck is pretty thick. So, I mean, I think it would take you a long time to realize what's in there. One other holdback of this game is there's only 2 characters. That's what you're going to be doing a lot, is just these same 2 guys kind of fighting back and forth. I think this game is going to be heavily reliant on the theme. If you kind of like the Penny Arcade license, I think you're more likely to win this game. From a gameplay standpoint, there's going to be a lot of luck involved going back and forth with these cards. The more you know your deck, I think the stronger you're going to be at playing it, and you can kind of wait around for certain cards to come out. But I think most turns, if you can play a stuff, a hijinks, an attack, I don't know why you wouldn't. At that point, it's just a matter of playing whichever one you prefer to play at that time. Sometimes I think decisions are rather obvious because some cards are just stronger than other cards, and it's really a race to get rid of the health of your opponent. So there's no reason to hold back on a good card for any timing purposes because you really don't know when they can block it. Penny Arcade, the card game. This is a bit of an older game from Fantasy Flight, that silver line that they had. What you get here is a game based on the Penny Arcade license. I'm not really sure what that is. I think it's some sort of webcomic. I've never read it. It's not really something I'm interested in, but I'm fairly aware that it's a larger phenomenon, perhaps on the internet, and people really enjoy this. And I think that might be who this game is for. If you're really into this license or theme, I think it may fit what you want it to be. It has a couple of the characters from it and some things going on to it and perhaps the humor of it. For the rest of us, I'm not sure this is a very strong game. There's a lot of luck in drawing cards, looking for the success symbols, which is okay. I don't mind that as much. It could have been rolling dice or could have been this, and this is just as well as anything to me, I suppose. It's a direct attack fighting game with cards, okay? So you only have two characters, which I feel like is a little bit limiting. They're a little bit different. The decks are different, which is good. But there's only two. So there never was any expansions for this. You're not going to add any more people to this. You're just stuck with the two. Which is fine because it's a two-player game and it does okay. I feel like it's one of those games you get to the table, you play, like, that was decent, and you'll put it back. I don't feel like it has the depth or the expansions to make it something you'll want to get. I think there's better two-player fighting games with cards than this one. I think the reason why you like this one is a couple reasons. One, it's fairly simple to understand. There's not a whole lot going on. Two, you'd be a fan of the license or IP. And three, the other ones like Yomi perhaps are just a little more complicated. You don't want all the characters. You just want to open something up, have two characters that have different decks, and you're able to get to the table and play rather quickly. This would accomplish them. All those things I said that were good about it could actually be negatives. You know, the lack of variety in characters. You only get two. The fact that kind of once you know the decks, perhaps, you know, a little bit easier. There's going to be no expansions for this. This is what it is. And if you're not a fan of the license or IP, I feel like it's not going to speak out to you. Nevertheless, this is a fine game, and I think when you look at it, you'll know if you like it or not. I feel like there's better games on the market. I think this one may have aged. I think the license or IP is really the draw here. Otherwise, I'd probably tell you to look elsewhere. But if you're looking for a very simple two-player fighting game, then this is it. But just keep in mind, I think there's a high luck factor in this one. But that's what I think about this one. I'm going to purge this one. I'm not going to keep Penny Arcade, the card game, around. I have no loyalty or whatever to the license, and I just don't feel like it's a strong enough card game. If I'm going to play a card game, I think I'm going to go somewhere else. And I've had this game for a while, and that is actually what I have done. Thanks for watching the video. I really appreciate you tuning in. If you liked it, please like it and hit that little subscribe button. That really helps out the channel. Lets us know that you're getting the videos that you want. If you agreed or disagree with what I said, feel free to comment below. I'd love to hear what you have to say, and I promise that I will comment back. Thanks for watching, and everybody else, keep playing games.